Hello and thank you for watching. This is Tassos with RF Elements, and I'm going to be taking you through a kind of quick start guide on how to use towercoverage.com with our antennas. Now, towercoverage.com is a third-party website. It's not our site or our tool, but it's a site that allows you to create coverage maps for your service area. And they have multiple vendors' antennas listed that you can build your site and see what kind of coverage you'd get with many different types of antennas. So today we're going to be doing our 30-degree symmetrical horn antenna. So once you're logged into the website, the first thing you need to do is you need to create a tower site location. So we go to New and Sites. And here you have a couple of options once you're inside. So you have to give it a site name, put in the latitude and longitude, the GPS coordinates, or if you want, you can simply put in an address or drop a pin on the map, right? So I like using the salt flats because it's, again, very flat and no obstructions, and that shows you, again, a very clear picture of what the antenna pattern looks like. So we'll put salt flats in there, hit enter. And you can see it quickly takes us out to the salt flats or in that region. And all we have to do now is just kind of click on the map where we want it to be, and it populates GPS coordinates. So we need to give it a site name. So we'll call it salt flats. And here we have to put the actual antenna height, or where, you know, the tower height. So we'll just say roughly doing a 150-foot tower. So now you click on create new sites. And if you go back to your dashboard, you should see now that the Salt Flats site has been created and it's ready to use. So once you've created your site, you now have to create your coverage map. So we'll go to New, Coverages. And here's the work area for that. So again, there's a lot of bells and whistles here. We're just gonna go through the basic settings. So you don't have to use a radio system. We just leave that blank. So we'll give this map a name and we'll call it SF30 test, because we're testing our 30-degree horn. Here's where we pick the tower site location, which we just created. So we'll go look in the list here and we see salt flats. So we'll pick it. You can see that the antenna height is auto-populated from when we created the site, so 46 meters is 150 feet roughly. The next part is the receiving station. So from this area here, we have to put what the average client height will be. So we'll just say that the average height for your CPE is roughly 30 feet. So go here, 30 feet. And then we have to put in the antenna gain. So we'll say it's roughly a 24 dB antenna gain, with roughly half a dB of loss due to connectors or pigtails. The next part is the transmission site transmitter info. So this is pretty much the most important part of the settings here. So we go choose antenna type. And again, you can see tower coverage has many different manufacturers' antennas listed. So we'll just go to RF Elements right now. And here you see a complete list of our horn antennas as well as our sector carrier class antennas, which we'll probably do a video of next. But we're going to pick the SHTP530, which is the symmetrical horn twist port 5 gigahertz 30 degree antenna. So we choose that, you see it's in the list. The next thing you have to do is you need to tell the system where the antenna is pointing, right? So we'll just leave it at 0 degrees or due north. Beam filter is the next thing that you want to look at. Again, this should be auto-populated. It's a 30-degree horn, so the beam width should be 30 degrees. If this number is different or missing, make sure you add it in there. We're not going to employ any down tilt because we're just looking for a basic map, but we need to put the antenna gain. So this particular antenna happens to be 18 dB, so we'll just do that. Then the next part is frequency. Again, this is very important. The default is 2400 megahertz or 2.4 gigahertz. And you can see here, there's a large list of selectable channels. We'll just go in the upper uni band here. We'll pick 5700 and we'll pick a channel like 5800. Okay. Then the next thing is the transmit power of your radio. So we'll say it's roughly 29 dB output power. And again, there's a transmit line loss, again, due to connectors and pigtails. We'll just leave it at the default of 0.5. Okay, the last part is the system performance. This is the maximum receive signal that you would want to see, right? So you're not gonna see anything that's worse than an -70, let's say. The next part that I like to adjust here is the strong signal margin, and you'll see this later in a coverage map. It's kind of the transition point or the difference between of 5 dB from the maximum signal level of -70. We'll make this 5, so you'll see the difference between -70 and -65 in the coverage map. The next thing is distance. Again, 20 kilometers is the default. We can leave it at that. That's roughly 10 miles, so that should be good. At that point, these are all the basic things that need to be done to get your basic coverage map. So we click Update Coverage. And then it brings us back out to our dashboard. And if we refresh the screen here, we can see that our SH30 test coverage map is now being created. It's processing. So this process is pretty quick. Again, towercoverage.com is a pretty powerful website. It usually is done in less than a minute, so it doesn't take very long. We'll try and refresh it here, and it's still processing, so we'll just wait a little bit longer, and it should be done here any second now. And we're still waiting. Maybe I should play some background music while we wait, but usually it doesn't take long. So here we go. Now we see that our Salt Flat 30 test coverage map is now complete. So if we click on it, we'll actually see the map. So here you go. This is the coverage map for our 30 degree antenna. Again, the red to green is that 5 dB of difference. So anywhere within the green should be 65, -65 or better. Anything in the red should be -72, -65. And anything outside of that area is worse than -70, right? So again, you have the option to do it. You can see very clean antenna, very solid 30 degree beam, no side lobes. So it's a very, very nice performing antenna. So the next thing that we'll do is we'll pop a point on this map over here, and we'll look at the actual path for this. So if we do path analysis, we just put in some generic site information here, hit save. It will generate a new map and show you the path calculation. So for that particular antenna, again, at the end of its coverage area is roughly about 8 miles, 7.75 miles. And you can expect to see an estimated -70 signal. So if we change that now, we pop it here in the green, we should see -65 or better. Here we go. So again, that's at roughly 4.2 miles away from the antenna, and you could see that the link is -64.7 or better. So again, that's the basic how-to for using towercoverage.com. Again, there's a lot of things you can do. It's a very powerful site, but we just wanted to take you through the quick setup to try and use our antennas and see how they would cover your area. Thanks again for watching. This is Tassos with RF Elements, and stay tuned for some more videos. Thanks. Have a good day.